Hey everybody, welcome to the Openly Hostile Opinions Podcast. We're available on iTunes, Google Play, YouTube, and your favorite podcasting platform. If you're enjoying what we do, be sure to subscribe, like, favorite, and review. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus. Feel free to drop us a line anytime.
Hello Jay, how are you doing?
Pretty good. How's it going, Casey?
It's going all right.
All right.
Welcome, everyone.
So what are we drinking today?
We are drinking a pumpkin unfiltered pumpkin ale by UFO. I don't know what the unfiltered means. Maybe it's royalty beer. I have no idea.
Unfiltered means there's still yeast in it.
Yeah, but it's just weird. Cheers.
Cheers. That's very pumpkin-y.
Oh, my God. Ooh. That's a really strange taste.
It's got a lot of spice to it.
Yeah, that's what I really don't like, the spice. The reason I got it, though, is because it's like a pumpkin spice gangbang outside. It's October, it's fall, everything.
You know, we're heading up to Halloween.
Yeah, every woman is dressed in the same clothes as Han Solo for some reason. Did you ever notice that with the boots and the vest?
Yeah,
looks just like Han Solo.
You're absolutely right. Yeah. The boots and the vest.
So I thought, you know, pumpkin spice. If you would rate this, what would you give it?
I like it. I'd give it at least a 7 out of 10.
Really? Ugh. I just.
I don't mind a malty spicy beer.
Is it giving you a bad aftertaste at all, or?
It's definitely got a little hint of cinnamon and nutmeg hanging around.
Yeah. If I would rate it, I'd give it one dead hooker out of 5. How about that?
One dead hooker out of 5?
Yeah, sure.
One dead hooker out of 5.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, that reminds me. Do you know what the good thing is about a dead hooker?
What's a good thing about a dead hooker?
You get the second round free. Yeah. There goes more of our viewers.
Oh, man. If you don't mind the smell, you know.
Yeah, how about it? So what's the first thing you got for us today, Jay?
All right, well, speaking of it being around Halloween, I actually have a good one for you here. Get this. Some dude in Arkansas is accused of murdering a 90-year-old woman, and he blames it on The Walking Dead.
Really?
Oh, yeah. You should see this guy, too. He looks like a fat, swollen... I don't even know. Dude's probably about 350 pounds, and he's just exactly what you'd expect a dude from Arkansas who blames a murder on The Walking Dead to look like.
Well, why does he blame The Walking Dead? What happened? Is he in love with one of the characters or something?
Here's the part that's just nuts. He wanted to feel what it felt like to kill somebody, which is...
Oh, good. Great.
Stereotypical serial killer MO. But he wanted to know that if he was in a situation like they have in The Walking Dead, if it was truly zombie apocalypse, would he be able to survive?
Wow.
That was his whole point. And somehow, apparently, a 90-year-old woman is equivalent to a zombie.
Yeah, that doesn't make it. I think he would choose someone a little stronger than you, you know, that still doesn't play with Care Bears. You know, maybe someone that could fight him back or... I'd pick someone a little different than a 9-year-old.
A 90.
Oh, 90. I'm sorry.
I was going to say, what about Care Bears with a 90-year-old?
That's even worse. Oh, actually, you know what? I could see behind this guy. He probably picked the 90-year-old because she walks as slow as a zombie, probably.
I don't know, man. Nowadays, you got them fast zombies. Yeah. You watch Resident Evil and shit, and they're chasing you around.
Yeah, and 28 Days Later and all that stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, so that was his story. He said he would have said anything at that point to keep him from taking his wife. All right, so he wanted to know if he could defend his family in the event of a zombie apocalypse. Okay, fine, but do you really have to go kill a 90-year-old woman?
Well, how did he kill her? Did he? Did he get, like, because I know, did you ever read those survival books for zombies or whatever, and they say use blunt weapons so it doesn't get stuck in the zombie, you don't lose, does he get that in depth?
No, this asshole just took a 38 caliber handgun and shot her right in the back of the head, you know, execution style.
That doesn't make, if you...
You know, because the zombie's going to bow down for you, yeah. and let you shoot him in the back of the head.
It's easy to shoot someone. So if you want to learn how to survive a zombie apocalypse, just shoot at targets. You don't have to actually... Like, I think it was just an excuse to kill someone. He's like, can I really kill... Oh, I'll blame it on The Walking Dead. You know,
yeah, there you go. I mean, clearly the guy's got mental issues, but here's the sad part. The lady's name was Lavinda Counts, and she wasn't found for 10 days. So
she looked like a zombie when they found her, basically.
God, you're horrible.
I know.
And that, folks, is why Casey's going to hell.
Yes, already there, guys. Woo!
Anyway, so nobody came to call on this woman for 10 days. So I hope you grandchildren out there feel like shit. Congratulations, yeah. Somebody murdered your grandma and you didn't go visit her.
Yes, it's bullshit. Bullshit.
Remember, folks, call your grandparents.
Yes. Tell them you love them. Either know they have those weird bowls of, like, car keys and just random pieces of cough drops and stuff in it. Everyone had a grandparent like that.
Yeah, and there's usually keys floating around in there, too.
Yeah.
You know, and an old button. You know, you're supposed to eat the button. That's not a choking hazard.
Yeah.
But, you know, I straight up ripped this off from some blog, but there's no chance a zombie apocalypse would ever happen in the first place. Oh, I know. I ruined it for all you nerds out there. I'm sorry. But there's no way a zombie apocalypse would even work. Because what are zombies but big walking bits of meat to any predators that are catching up with them?
So it's like hookers, basically.
You and the hooker thing.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I don't know what the hooker thing is. I guess I just got them on my mind or something. I've never bought a hooker before because I'm not rich, but whatever.
Yeah, well, you apparently need to get laid by the sounds of things.
Yeah, thank you.
But anyway, all you'd have to do is head north where it gets cold. And as soon as winter sets in, zombies are big walking balloons of water that are going to frostbite.
Yes.
If you've ever left the chicken cutlet in the freezer, same idea.
Yeah.
All right, so what do you got for us?
Well, first of all, I got a couple videos today for the people that are just listening to our podcast. We'll put the links down so you can watch them later. But there's... I like Instagram. It's something to do when I'm bored. I take a smoke
break. So are hookers.
Yeah, exactly. dead hookers. I keep seeing this thing come across of people doing satisfying things. And there's a name to it. You know food porn?
Yeah.
Well, there's this thing called process porn now.
Process porn?
Yes, it's fucking weird. You think my hooker obsession's weird. This is just, it takes it back. And one of the most popular ones I see is people cutting sand.
Cutting sand?
Yes, it's...
How does one cut sand exactly?
They mold them, like the one that we're looking at right now is a block of brown sand, and they take things like scissors and knives, and they cut the sand into slices, and it's supposed to be satisfying for people.
Okay, wait, stop. How do you get the sand to cut? I mean, is this one of these things where you mix it with water? Is it like building a sandcastle as a child?
I don't know. I don't know if they get... what's that magical sand that kids are fucking playing with these days?
Kinetic sand?
Yeah, something like that. And, it's just... And the name of this Instagram person, it's called Sandisfying. And see, I don't know if people, like, you know, touch themselves with this stuff or whatever, but it's supposed to be, you know... satisfying, I guess. If
it's the internet, of course, yes. Somebody's touching themselves to it.
There's also ones where there's things where people are pouring color into paint and swirling it around. That's supposed to be very satisfying.
Okay, you know what? To be honest with you, that'd be pretty dope.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. But the sand thing, I just like if we can go ahead and watch this real quick. Like it's
okay. So a guy is taking a knife into a block of molded sand
and just cutting. That's all it is.
It looks like somebody's cutting into, like, liverwurst or something.
Yeah, it does. It sort of looks like liverwurst. But it gets thousands of views. And is this going to turn into a cult? Like the sand people or something? It's just... That's the first one. And then they do
Where
other things.
Where do you find this shit?
It's Instagram, man. But and there's other ones where they take a hydraulic press and they smush it.
I've seen the hydraulic press channel.
It's all called process porn.
Well, the hydraulic press channel is pretty awesome.
Yeah, that is. They pressed the other day. I saw something like they pressed a 20-layer ham sandwich or something. That was really crazy.
Now, my favorite one that they've done so far is, you know, you can only fold a piece of paper so many times, like seven, I think it is. Mm. They were able to fold it a lot more by using the hydraulic press.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's not really at that point folding so much as pulverizing, but
yeah.
Hey.
That's the same thing, yeah, basically. Here's one with scissors. It sort of looks like they took an old sand castle bucket and they put a lump of sand and they're cutting it with scissors. And...
And people are getting off to this.
Yes. 88,000 views for this.
And we're getting 100.
and this guy is cutting purple sand with scissors. It looks like, you know, the purple Teletubby's dick. And
you know what? They got something going on here because we're sitting here talking about it.
I know. And that's another thing. It's called Sand is Fying. After the sand, there's a dot. You can find them on Instagram if you want to watch these videos. There's hundreds and hundreds. There's black sand. There's one where he takes sort of like an apple cutter.
Oh, for God's sake.
Yeah, like, it's...
If any of you people are oddly erect right now, we'll put a link in the description for you.
Well, I was, but I punched myself a couple times, and now I'm better, but... Look at that. So,
good Lord, man.
Yeah, it's... That's pretty funny. Like, what's next? Are you gonna think there's food porn? There's food porn. There's sand porn now, basically. Processed porn. What's next?
What was that one you told me about a long time ago? Like, fat chicks sitting on cakes and farting on them?
Oh, yeah. A long time ago, my friend, yeah, exactly. He's like, hey, man, I want to show you this. I'm like, what is it? Well, this girl made a website, and it was a girl that makes cakes. They show the process of her making the cake. She puts icing on. There's all music, like ding, 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 music going. Excuse me. And then she gets butt-ass naked. She sits on the cake and farts on him for like 5 minutes straight. And she gets some people pay her to do this.
Money.
Exactly. Gotta get those Benjamins. And it's just, ugh.
Well, you know what? They don't have to work for a living anymore, and we do, so they got something figured out there.
Yeah, that's very true.
Speaking about people who don't have to work for a living, that leads me into my next story for you. Did you hear Kim Kardashian got robbed?
What, of her soul? Oh, wait, she didn't have one. Never mind.
Well, she went to the Paris Fashion Week this week, and she was there, and she was staying in some hotel. It wasn't a hotel. It was like a private residence that they rent out for celebrities, I guess. And a few guys dressed as police officers conned the concierge into taking them to a room. And they hogtied her and threw her in the bathtub and stole a whole shitload of jewelry. $6.5 million worth in U.S. money.
They actually went that far of dressing up like cops.
Well, obviously the concierge bought it, so they must have been pretty convincing.
Did they say anything about they knew she had this much money on her, or they just had this fantasy of hogtying Kim Kardashian?
To be fair, there's probably a lot of people out there with a fantasy of hogtying Kim Kardashian. I am not one of them, but yeah. Anyway. I don't know, because they didn't speak English. They only spoke French, and I guess they kept repeating ring, ring, because Kanye gave her this giant diamond ring. Yeah. So they took that and $6.5 million worth of jewelry. And like I said, they hogtied her, threw her in the bathtub, and eventually her bodyguard showed up a few minutes later. Her stylist was in the house with her. And when her stylist heard the commotion going on, she locked herself in the bathroom and texted the bodyguard. I guess 911 didn't work from her phone or something along those lines. But, I mean, that's pretty horrible. Kanye was in the middle of a performance and actually stopped his set immediately and said, hey, I got family problems, I gotta go.
Yeah.
Which, considering what a piece of shit Kanye West is,
nah.
I gotta commit it to it. Commend him for that, at least.
Wait. I'll let you finish, but... I'll let you finish, but, you know...
The whole Kim Kardashian thing was almost a big story, though, because that day, mm-hmm. she was at the awards and she was wearing, quote-unquote, no makeup. You guys have got to see this picture. If this is no makeup, then I'm a horse's uncle.
Yeah, I remember you showing that to me yesterday.
Yeah, nobody's lashes are that long. Nobody's lips are that color, you know. They saying she only has moisturizer. Well, you know what? If that's just moisturizer, I want to get a hold of that moisturizer. Yeah,
exactly.
That's got to be like some 10 grand moisturizer.
Yeah. And that's the thing. I don't wear makeup, whatever, obviously.
Well, of course not.
Obviously. But
you're so dashingly beautiful, naturally.
I know, but I've been around enough dead hookers, you know. to basically know that the first glance at that picture, she's obviously wearing something.
Yeah, there's no way that's no makeup.
Besides her resting bitch face, which is always on. But that's her eyelashes have stuff on it. Her face is obviously has something on it. You know, it's...
Yeah, there's no way that's no makeup. I mean, a lot of women are doing the no makeup thing right now. The most famous is Alicia Keys. And Adele just posted a video the other day of her no makeup. She was sick. So if anybody can do no makeup and somebody's sick, she had to cancel a concert in Phoenix, I think it was, because she had a cold and couldn't sing and she was really sorry and whatever. More power to you. If you got the face for it, do it. Mm-hmm. I mean, to support the movement, I'm doing the no hat movement today. Yeah. So I'm rocking the no hat because I don't want to be covered up.
Well, I guess we're against each other then, because I love hats. They're amazing.
Fuck you and your hats,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. How dare you have an opinion, Jay?
You're not allowed to stand up against hats.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. I'm the one against hats. Fuck yeah, this. Fuck. I don't even know what I believe in anymore.
Yeah. Either
do I. I hate everyone.
Yeah. So, basically, did she get hurt at all? Anything like that?
No, she wasn't hurt. She was afraid she was going to be raped, obviously.
Well, every woman has that fantasy. I mean, fear. Sorry.
Well, pretty much when you get hog-tied and they duct tape your hands and shit together, you probably are concerned a little bit for your
vaginal
regions.
Exactly, and I thought that's where that was going at first, but...
Well, thank God she didn't. I mean, the woman's famous for nothing, but I don't wish harm on her.
I know, and that's, you know, you hear her getting robbed and it's like, whatever talent, because what does she do? I think, what was the one interview she had? I think it was like Barbara Streisand or something. I don't fucking know. She doesn't even do interviews, but... they straight up just, why are you famous? I remember that. Like, they were asking her, why are you famous? What do you even do?
She started out as the stylist for Paris Hilton. And then from there, somebody found her interesting. I have no idea who. But somebody found her interesting enough to give her own show, Keeping Up with the Kardashians, and her rest of her brood and the fucking Jenner brood and all that shit are all together.
Oh, man, that's fucking crazy. But the no makeup thing, what are they standing up against?
Well, Alicia Keys said that she's doing it because she doesn't feel like being covered. She doesn't want to cover her heart, doesn't want to cover her soul, doesn't want to cover herself in makeup. She wants to be herself. And you know what? She's got the face for it.
Yeah.
I've seen her. She looked fine. She looked whatever. You know, plain, of course. But... I don't... She straight up said that because I'm not wearing makeup does not mean I'm anti-makeup.
Yeah.
So, if you choose to wear makeup or you're just one of the people that you can't get away without it, that's fine. Like me, I can't get away without wearing a shirt. I'm a fat dude.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to go mowing my lawn without a shirt on. I consider it a public service.
Yes. Yeah.
And no, can the rest of you fat people out in the audience here, I'm amongst you.
Yes.
Please keep your shirt on. Yes. No one wants to see that.
No one wants those sweaty man titties bouncing around everywhere.
Even worse are those fucking leggings. Leggings are not pants.
Yeah.
Leggings are meant to be worn underpants.
Yeah. Don't even get me started on leggings. Sometimes I go and I swear, like, they're 100 yards from me and I can smell it. That's how clean, like, that's how thin these people's pants are. Yeah. Exactly. It's just, it's ridiculous. Thank God I'm not a woman, because I'd probably wear leggings and, you know, it would look like a roast beef sandwich wrapped in saran wrap.
God. Now, as sexy as you are, those leggings would look good.
Oh, yeah. I got to get the UGG boots. Got to get a Starbucks cup. Get the white girl thing going.
If you're wearing the dark, opaque ones that keep everything covered up, that's fine. But if you're seeing your Hello Kitty underpants through them, stop.
I know, and like I go out in public and I see a lot of that, and it's like, do they know what they look like at all?
I don't think they do.
And that's the thing, I don't think they do either, because
if they did, they'd have the decency to not do that.
I know, I don't even like going out in public dressed normal. How do these people go out in public wearing this stuff? And it's become a famous thing. Like, look at people's at Walmart. Like, you can go to that website and just find crazy amounts of people just dressed. I guess people just don't give a fuck, I guess.
It's to be commended, I guess. I mean, I can't go out of the house and not concern myself a little bit about what I'm looking like.
Yeah, like, I don't want to, you know, look like one of those clowns walking around that everyone's seeing. Like, I remember reading about 3 years ago or something like that. Some guy was doing it in England, But now I guess it caught up and everyone's doing it.
Well, it's been going on since the 70s, I guess. People are seeing these clowns. And, in fact, this is one of the things I wanted to talk about today since Halloween's coming. Everybody's dressing up in this clown shit. Correction. Phantom clowns have been terrorizing the U.S. since 1981, according to my fact checkers. Huh. Fort Wayne, Indiana, some jackass who was wearing a clown outfit got shot.
Really?
Yep.
I'm surprised it took this long.
Yeah,
creepy
yeah.
Motherfuckers.
The quote is the best thing in the world. Right, who is the... Oh, where was he? I'm not sure what he was. I think he might have been the police spokesman.
Mm-hmm.
Either that or the local. Either way, he said, it isn't the first shooting that's happened on the street. They happen often down the street. And he goes, I think it's just crazy. People better take those clown masks off before the coroner does. Isn't that beautiful? I want that shit knitted into one of those wall hangings with the needle point.
Yeah, that looks all sweet. Has butterflies flying around it.
Oh, my God, yeah. Yeah. If any of our audience members are out there who can do needlepoint, please make us one that says, people better take those clown masks off before the coroner does. I want it. I'll hang it on the wall.
Yeah,
I'm not kidding.
We'll put it back here.
If you're watching us on YouTube, it will be on there.
Yes,
if you make it, we'll display it.
We need more knickknacks, and that's the best thing right there.
Yeah, if anybody has anything they want to send to us, you can get in touch with us on one of our social medias, which we'll have in the links below the description.
Yeah, we'll put anything back there except naked pictures of me that aren't floating around on the internet.
Naked pictures in general. This is a family friendly show. Fucking goddamn it!
I know. Fucking shit. Christ and cunt. So, who shot him? Does it say anything about? Was it a woman? Was it a man?
No, the story I'm looking at is very sparse on information. It just said, a colored SUV pulled alongside the clown. A man was driving. That man got out of the car and fired several shots, so it was a man. You're right.
Some guy was like, I'm fucking fed up. I am fed up with this shit. I'm shooting a fucking clown today. And I'm just surprised it took this long because it's been getting more popular, more popular. It's been going on for a couple months now that I've seen.
You know what? I've seen it. You can shoot all the fucking clowns you want to.
Exactly.
Hell, I like you. You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
Just make sure she's not dressed up like a clown.
Just do it!
Kill them clowns, man. Not really. Please
no.
Don't come after us for inciting
please.
Riots.
Because I don't even dress like a clown. I have a huge fucking nose, so I already look like one.
Yeah, you paint that shit red, and you're pretty much Bozo incarnate.
Yes. Women like me for my nose, not my genitals.
Nobody likes your genitals.
Yeah, no one likes. I don't even like me. But anyways, getting off subject here. Was this the first shooting to happen?
As far as I'm aware, it is.
Okay.
Although I'd imagine if you're a dumbass who's fucking climbing out of the woods in a clown outfit, if you get shot, it's on you, buddy.
Yeah.
I mean, it's pretty much common knowledge at this point. People don't like clowns.
Yeah, there's clowns. There's so many phobias these days. There's a phobia of being afraid of phobias. Just don't scare people. Yeah, I know, it's fucking weird.
A phobia of being afraid of phobias.
A phobia of being afraid of having a phobia. There's phobia of balloons and everything. Don't.
That's a self-fulfilling prophecy right there.
I know, it's fucking crazy. Just don't do this shit, or you're gonna get fucking shot.
Well, you know, everybody, I can see some dumbass teenager going, oh, everybody's talking about these clowns, I'm gonna go dress up like a clown.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what it was. I want to say that this was a kid, I think.
The kid that got shot, or it was a kid that shot the clown?
No. I think the guy who was dressed as a clown was a teenager or something. Oh, no, it doesn't say it on here, but I think I remember reading that elsewhere. I might be wrong. It's possible. It's happened once or twice before, I know. As awesome as I am, it's hard to believe, but I have been wrong once or twice before. But, you know, this whole thing in recent memory started in South Carolina, and it really is creepy. I don't know if it's a hoax or what, but these kids were starting to say that this family of clowns live deep in the woods next to a pond behind their apartment complex.
Did they live in the pond?
I don't know.
And how many were of them? Did they all, like, do they live in the water and they all come out?
The words were the a family like, of clowns.
And the pond's like the size of a puddle. It's like a clown car. They just all, like, there's hundreds of them coming out of the water. And it's like the size of a little puddle there.
Oh, that's fantastic. That is fantastic. So, no.
Not only is there just single people doing it, but now there's families of clowns, basically.
Yes, there's gaggles of clowns. What was a group of clowns called? A clown car?
Yeah, I guess. A clown bang? I don't know.
A clown bang?
I
could you imagine a bunch of clowns getting into it, man? It just smelled like grease paint and sadness.
Yeah, and cotton candies flying everywhere, fucking...
Oh, my God, the stickiness.
Yeah, people are smacking each other with their shoes. Ugh.
By the time they're done, they'd all be brown because all the colors of their faces would all mix together.
And that actually reminds me, since we have a beer that we drink, I was watching a live stream the other day. I watched a lot of Twitch and stuff, and some guy, I think I've told you this, was drinking a beer called Clown Shoes.
Clown Shoes?
Yes, and I guess apparently it's very high alcohol, and when you drink it, you get pretty
intoxicated. You go fucking clown shoes.
Yeah, you basically walk around okay. And you feel like, I'm going to try to get my hands on it sometime.
Just do it!
Exactly, I will. And we're going to try that, and we're going to walk around and see if it feels like we have clown shoes on or not.
I think it's an expression. People are saying stuff is fucking clown shoes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why, but whatever. I guess I'm uncultured.
So fam's on its way out?
Fam.
Ugh.
If you say fam or you say bae, you can kiss my ass.
Yeah, isn't bae something like they found out it's something like a taint douche or something?
Bae's short for baby, I think.
I know,
like,
but
you're bae.
Yeah, I know that, but then they look into it and it's actually a slang term for like something really disgusting, like a blue waffle, something to that extent.
Don't look that up.
Yeah, don't Google blue waffle. Yeah.
Don't do that.
If you do, get a puke bucket ready or. Yeah, exactly. And, you know, maybe some lube if you're into that stuff. I don't know. But just, yeah, don't Google blue waffle.
don't do that.
Yeah, it's... Ugh.
Just do it!
Well, you heard Shia LaBeouf. He said just do it. So.
Yeah. You
don't blame me, though.
You gotta listen to that crazy guy because, you know... So basically, I'm gonna talk about something happy for a change.
Fantastic.
Yeah, we have a lot of negativity on here, you know, dead hookers, clowns getting shot.
Hey, why not?
Blue waffle porn, whatever we were talking about. This is another thing. I guess I'm on a social media kick lately. I've seen this on Facebook. It's everywhere I've seen it. Have you seen this yet? It's a fucking dick. It's a grandfather. He gets light-up shoes. I don't know if it's birthday. I don't know if... I don't know, he's going to die soon and they feel bad for him.
Well, maybe they just want to find Grandpa, like when he wanders out at night and shit.
Yeah, that's probably what it is. He gets all senile and he's like, you know, just going nuts. But it's this older guy, he gets light-up shoes and he just fucking freaks. He goes insane. It's like the best day of his life.
I have not seen it.
It's we'll watch it here real quick.
Can we get the audio?
Yeah.
Get out of town!
Get out of town!
What? Fuck!
Alright, so Grandpa opened the box, grabbed the shoes out, they lit up, and he's freaking out.
Oh, a dream come true.
A dream come true. You know what? I wish I was that easily amused at this point in my life.
I know. I'm just glad that an old guy is saying something besides whippersnappers. And he's, you know, it's
when
like,
the hell did you hear an old man say whippersnappers?
You know, they're always sitting on their front fucking porch, and you're just walking down.
This
the
coming from a man who's never been around the elderly, apparently.
Oh no, I've been there. I remember going to nursing homes when I was younger and walking in, and all these old people, they look like, you know, The Walking Dead. We were speaking about that, and they're like, "Are you here to see me?" And they're like touching me and stuff. It was horrible. It looked like something like a Madonna video in the 80s. it was horrible, but. You know, the old people always sitting yelling at kids, "Get off my lawn, you young whippersnappers." I'm glad I'm seeing a guy say something besides that.
God, you're awful.
I know.
You are just awful.
I know.
You're a terrible human being.
I know. I tell myself that every day, and so does everyone else. But
you also have no self-esteem, apparently.
I know. But do you think this guy had a bad life or something? Why is he so excited
about
lineup?
Why you gotta read into shit, Dr. Phil?
Because...
Maybe he's just happy because he got some light-up shoes.
I know, but...
I'm a grown fucking man. I'd like some light-up shoes.
I know, but I just don't get the point, man.
Maybe he just likes light-up things.
I guess. I don't know. Like, is he a cat? I don't know.
Everything's got to have an ulterior motive with you. It just can't be somebody's fucking happy because they got some light-up shoes. No!
Well, that's the thing, man. We always talk about depressing stuff. You know, people are shooting 90-year-old women. You know,
well, that's what's on the news.
Probably beat her to death with her tennis ball walker, you know. but it is nice to see something positive every once in a while. It's just, what kind of life has this guy had that this makes him that excited? Would you ever get that excited? I don't think
I would get that. If somebody bought me light up shoes right now, I'd be ecstatic.
You would tell him to get out of town.
I'd be like, get the fuck out of here.
I'd be like, get the fuck out of Dodge.
You got me light up shoes? We're cool, man. We're cool. If your worst enemy comes up to after 20 years of a rivalry and says, you know what? I'm sorry, man. Here's some light up shoes. You would forgive that man in a heartbeat.
Yeah, I probably would.
Yeah.
I'd be like, you light up my life.
Who doesn't want some fucking light up shoes?
I know. Like, watching that video, I think I want to go and buy a pair.
He's getting ready for Halloween. You gotta be seen when you're doing You gotta be seen when you're doing Halloween.
Yeah, he's like, I don't want a reflector thing. I don't want to wear a reflecting vest or
light up shoes.
Just light up shoes.
Halloween's coming way too soon.
I know. I was just talking to your mother about this actually. Does it seem like people are getting more excited about Halloween?
As I get older, I'm actually getting less excited, which is terrible because it was always my favorite holiday as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
You know, though, I have two little girls. If you're unfamiliar with me, I have two little girls, and they're both of Halloweening age. And nowadays, man, the costumes are so much better. Do you remember when we were kids and they had those little crunchy plastic face masks
that
cut your face and shit?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You could never see out of the fucking things.
Yeah. They still have those, because I was just at Walmart the other day, and they still have those. And I'm like, and I got this overwhelming feeling of just hate. I was like, fucking parents made me wear those. Horrible, because you couldn't breathe in them. They smelled like shit.
Well, any mask smells like shit, though.
Yeah, they had, but everything's just got crazy upgraded.
Well, when you were a little kid, you would have learned to brush your fucking teeth. It wouldn't have smelled that bad.
Fuck you. But they had a Donald Trump mask at Walmart, which, you know, Walmart's getting political now, I guess.
Tell me it had pursed lips.
Yeah. The costumes are getting out of control. There's so much shit. You could get anything. There was just everything. And I just feel like I don't remember Halloween being this big deal when I was younger. And
I loved Halloween when I was a kid. Man. I know, Halloween was huge.
Yeah, but it seems like adults are getting more happy about it.
Our generation is starting to have kids now. And our generation lives off of nostalgia a lot.
Yes, that's true. I think because of the internet.
Yeah, it's exactly it. I think the internet has a lot to do with it because we can constantly be reminded of things that we had in the past. Mm-hmm. The problem is, though, we look at it through rose-colored glasses most of the time.
Yeah.
Like, for example, my kids love the Ninja Turtles. Well, my youngest kid loves the Ninja Turtles, and I was so fucking excited.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they've got the new Ninja Turtles now, and it's on Nickelodeon, and I like it. It's a good show. It's not as good as the 2003 one. Yeah, okay, whatever. I'm being elitist, but it was good. So I decided to go back and show her some of the ones from 1987. Mm-hmm. You know, the ones we grew up with.
Yeah.
Don't go back and watch those.
I know. I did it one night. And
they're cringy.
Like, yep.
They are so cringy.
It makes you feel old. It makes you feel...
Oh, my God, I was so entertained by that. That was my favorite thing in the world.
And there is still some funny parts. Like, I remember, I think it's the second one where... that guy's delivering pizza and those people are robbing the place.
Oh, I'm not talking about the movies. The movies are fucking badass.
Oh, okay. What were you talking
about? No, I'm talking about the cartoon show.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Those are so cringy. The movies were badass. Yeah. They're still great.
I know. Like I was saying.
In no small part because Judith Hogue played April in the first one.
Yeah, yeah. It's like barbecue ribs.
Barbecue salt.
not the joke. Not the Bill Cosby barbecue sauce, because we know he puts in that.
But you got them Quaaludes.
Yeah, those Quaaludes, dog. But anyways, I was cracking up when I watched the movies. It was about a year ago, I think. I just watched all three of them. And the part where they're fighting, it's the opening credits of the second one. They're fighting.
Yeah, where Michelangelo grabs those meat sticks and beats the hell out of people.
And he's fighting the one guy. He jumps off and he just randomly says, "You want a pickle?" I crack up at that part every time where Donnie acts like he's one of those leaning back things.
Yeah,
and he's like, yeah.
Yeah, the one that didn't have Corey Feldman as the voice.
Yeah.
I love Corey Feldman. He's nuts as shit.
Of course he is.
You should see him. He has a music career now for some God-forbidden reason. He sounds just like Michael Jackson.
Without the boy touch.
I'm pretty sure he got touched by Michael Jackson, which is why he denies it, but he did pal around the Neverland Ranch on occasion.
Got free tickets.
But his music, he's really trying to sound hard like Michael Jackson. It's creepy. If you get an opportunity, go listen.
Wasn't he just on a talk show or something? I thought I saw.
I didn't see it.
There was some viral video about him. He had this really creepy performance or something.
Everything he does is creepy.
Yeah, I forget what it was. Maybe it was, I don't know. Does Carson Daly do shit these days? I don't fucking know.
I don't know, man. I remember him from TRL Live.
The
Total Request Live.
The Mbop and what else? The Thong Song, Cisco. That was popular. That was number one for like fucking 3 years.
I remember when that terrible fucking Korn song was, they couldn't knock it out of the charts. Got the Life, I think it was.
Oh, yeah. That was on for a long time. Yeah, I remember it was always Mbop. That fucking bullshit. I guess, and speaking of that, they have their own beer now. We got to get that on. It's called Mhop.
Hey, why not? Speaking of Korn, I got to tell the audience this story. Casey knows this story already, but I got to tell you.
Yeah, this is great.
A long time ago, I was on the Opie and Anthony show. I won tickets to go see the show, and Korn was performing. I hate Korn. I've always hated Korn. I know it's my generation. I should love them.
It gets in your poop.
I can't stand them. Yeah, the only Korn I like is the Tracers in your stool. But so Korn is on the Opie and Anthony show, and they're doing a acoustic set. And I was truck driving at the time because I apparently am an idiot and thought I could do that for a living. It didn't work out well. But anyway, so I did this. And I won these tickets, and I took my wife to go see Opie and Anthony and Korn, and I was there to see the Opie and Anthony show. But we're in between shows. They used to do half of their show in the studio in New York, and then they'd walk over to the SiriusXM studios. And in between that, there was a few minutes of commercial break, and my wife wanted to get a picture with Jonathan Davis. So she goes over, and he was super cool about it. He was a super, super nice human being.
I know, that makes this story even worse.
I know, it does. He and Monkey, the guitar player Monkey, they were both super cool human beings. They drove all through the night. They hadn't slept at all, but they were here with us, and they wanted to make it special and take pictures and sign shit. So my wife, being the little Korn fan she is, got to get a picture with Jonathan Davis, and she was so excited. And then Jonathan Davis looks at me and goes, "Hey, you want a picture too?" And I'm like, "Nah, I'm good."
Yeah, you fuck it. You think I'm a piece of shit. You call me a piece of shit. That is just...
I wasn't mean to the guy, but it's like I could have just been like, yeah, let me go take a picture. Like, yeah. Did I have to color it with a... Nah, I fucking hate Korn. Fuck you.
Yeah. But
no, I'm good.
You probably...
Yeah, and now I'm sure Jonathan Davis, with all of his fucking... Golden mansions and fucking fucking platinum Rolls Royces, doesn't give a shit or even remember me. But if I ever see the man, I'm gonna say I'm sorry. So Jonathan Davis, if you happen to watch our little radio show, that was me. I'm a dick. I'm sorry. Just because I don't particularly care for your music doesn't mean I shouldn't have just humored you for that moment. So yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you should have. Even as soulless as I am, I would have been like, yeah, okay, I'll take it. I'll even grab your dick if you want. Whatever.
I mean, I should have known the man would be sensitive. I mean, what? Did what? Get raped in the ass by his father.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, that wasn't appropriate.
Oh, it's okay. Whatever. It happens. Yeah. Yeah, let's get some beeps in there. the funny thing about that is, like, imagine if he's actually remembered this.
If he did, he's probably...
And he's like, that sick son of a bitch. That cowardly lion Wizard of Oz looking motherfucker. you know, and watch that he probably wrote a song about you, and we don't even know.
Yeah, it probably is.
It's like some angry song that's like that fucking cocksucker.
He doesn't remember me.
I know. I have an
imagination. Maybe he does, though. Now you got me wondering.
Yeah, I have an imagination, so I'm just thinking that he's probably like, he probably has like a shrine in his closet of you, and he's plotting to kill you some. Maybe he's gonna hog tie you in a hotel and steal your jewelry.
Put me in a bathtub.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe he has something planned.
It's because I didn't wear makeup.
Yeah. No hat. Yeah. We should start something on Twitter like
the no hat movement.
Yeah, no hat Friday or something, because that's the fucking
popular. We're gonna piss everybody off and nobody will ever listen to our show again.
Oh no, it's not. Everyone's already not listening, so it's okay.
Yeah, really, all of our four followers.
Yeah.
Hi out there.
Yeah, hey,
hi four people who like us.
Yeah. We're gonna piss people off. It doesn't really matter.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
You know what? If you get that easily offended, I'm terribly sorry. I will hold your hand and help you through the tough times.
Yeah, we'll take you and make you ride go-karts so you can smell the flowers, whatever the fuck people do to calm down these days. Play golf.
I don't know, man, but if you buy me a go-kart ride, I'd be pretty all right with that.
Fuck
the light-up shoes. Yeah, I want a go-kart ride.
Get out of town.
Fucking go-kart rides and shit.
We need to bring that saying back. I know it was probably around the time of like 1910 or whatever when they used that, but we need to bring that. Let's just start saying it.
Get out of town.
Yeah, get out of town. Like, we work at a restaurant, so we can probably make this work because we'll just start saying it. Like, don't even like have a conversation with me. Say you're just going to the bathroom, you pass me, just be like, get out of town.
Get out of town.
And people are just like, what the fuck? Did they forget to take their meds today or what's up?
People already do that with us.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. Actually, we should buy a pair of light-up shoes and wear them to work.
If I wasn't poor, I would straight up do that.
Yeah, I didn't even know they still made them, to tell you the truth. I thought it was an older video. I guess it's newer. I forgot to look at the date, but it's, I don't know. Get out of town. Get out of town. Do you have anything else for us that you want to talk about?
Absolutely.
Oh, this.
I got a beautiful one for you.
This must be interesting with that tone of voice.
Yes, I absolutely do. I read something about this the other day. A New Jersey beachgoer arrested for wearing plastic wrap bikini. And no, it is not a woman. In fact, you know what he looks like? Did you ever see Coach?
Oh my God, who was the guy that played that fucking...
Craig T. Nelson. Yeah. But no, not he doesn't look like Craig T. Nelson. He looks like the assistant coach, which was Jerry Van Dyke. Which was is Dick Van Dyke's younger brother, mm-hmm. Jerry Van Dyke.
Okay.
This guy looks like Jerry Van Dyke. And he
oh my God, yeah.
Yeah, he's a cute one. He he's a 59-year-old man who wore a bikini made out of saran wrap, essentially. And he wore it for days. That's the funniest part. It took these cops days after receiving complaints that this guy's running around in a fucking saran wrap bikini to come and put a stop to it.
So he was just running around and just how many?
Having a good old time. A couple of days, like 2 or 3 days. Having a good old time wearing a see-through bikini, harassing the locals, I assume. He's on Long Beach Island in New Jersey. I don't know whether he lives there or whether he was just visiting. Here's what's great. One of the local Fox affiliates tried to call him, and a woman answered the phone and said, "Nobody's here," and hung up. Of all the shit though that you're gonna say, "Nobody's here." Yeah. If you answered the phone, somebody's there.
Yeah, if I was him and people were calling, I would have took saran wrap up to the phone and just like rubbed my hand on it.
Fucking creepy ass Buffalo Bill shit.
Yep.
He rubs the saran wrap on the phone or he gets the hose again.
Yeah, exactly. I would have rubbed it and be like, I'm everywhere.
Speaking of, back in the day when I used to drive truck, man, for some fucking reason, everywhere I went, somebody on the Trucker Channel would always go, "I ain't wearing any panties." And I have to imagine it's only one dude.
Oh,
like, he just has the fastest truck in the fucking world.
Oh, yeah, and he's bored.
Because he has to have the fastest truck in the fucking world, because I refuse to believe it's more than one dude. It has to be one. Mm-hmm. Just one guy.
Oh, probably. He's probably bored, and he's like, God, what am I going to do? I'll just fuck with people.
I'm hoping so, because, man, he sounded pretty creepy. He sounded like about 400 pounds.
Oh, yeah. Probably, you know, folding whole waffles and half dipping them in syrup, biting them, just, you know, taking them, eating them in one bite. He's probably, like, you know, has six types of diabetes, if that's even possible.
You know, that was pretty vivid. Inside, you're a fat guy, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Inside.
Yeah, I just don't gain weight for some reason. Well, I sort of do, but I don't know. I'm wearing a bra today. But I did want to ask, though, did this guy run around with this on?
Or
did
he was on the beach.
So he was running around playing, like...
I don't know. He's 59 years old. I don't know how much running around he was doing.
There was like sun glistening. The guy, he's running around. There's like sunshine in my shoes.
I mean...
John Denver's playing in the background.
the sun glistening off of his silver hair.
Yeah.
You know, while he's playing in the ocean mist.
Yeah. I would at least had fun with it, though.
How do you not have fun wearing a fucking clear bikini?
I just, like I said, my imagination. What do they call it?
There's no pictures of the bikini in question.
I don't know. I'm upset about that, actually.
I want to know if the top's included. Did he wear a bottom and a top? Why would you say bikini?
Yeah.
Instead of, like, briefs.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking that dude was rocking a top and bottom sort of set.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I looked to see if there was any sort of a quote. I was hoping he was going to tell me it was because he didn't want to have tan lines.
That's actually a good point. Now watch. Every woman out there hates tan lines is going to do this. They're going to be like, Saran Wrap.
Where's the problem with this?
Yeah, this is amazing. Actually, yeah, some guy's probably going to vent, you know, clear something, you know, bikinis so that you don't get tan.
I'm pretty sure they exist already.
Yeah, probably.
You just got to go to France where they don't shave their pits.
Yeah, exactly. They make potpourri now. They make potpourri now that makes your shit smell good. They call it poopery, so...
I thought that was an SNL gag. Are you serious?
Oh, no, that's a real thing.
Does it help with farts?
I don't know, actually. That's probably a good point. But actually, speaking of that, they do make underwear that when you fart, it makes it smell like mint. So, I guess...
I like the taste of mint, but the smell is not that wonderful.
Yeah, nah. The smell of a six-day... gas station sandwich and, you know, mint probably doesn't smell that.
It's the ones that give you those hallucinogenic worms.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it was an episode of Futurama, wasn't it?
Yeah,
I remember that. God.
Can we bring Futurama back?
Yeah, I know.
I miss Futurama. I know a lot of people were saying the last season sucked, but I thought it was good. I thought it was still Futurama. I mean, this is the only show that I ever thought of that came up with some sort of a math problem and came up with an equation to prove it. I'm talking off the top of my head here, so I can't sit here and tell you which episode it was off the top of my head. Mm-hmm. But the Globetrotters were in it, and Bubblegum Tate and those guys all figured out this mathematical equation to prove it. It's the one where Bender and the other people started switching bodies, and they did a mathematical equation to prove how many switches were needed to put everybody back in their proper bodies. Who the fuck does that shit?
Yep. And
that show is brilliant.
I know. I love that show. And I'm a big Simpsons fan. I love the Simpsons. But
so do I. Who doesn't?
Yeah, I seriously contemplate. I don't know. I think I liked Futurama better than the Simpsons. I know everyone's like getting on their, oh, gee, no. Like, just, you know.
No, I love Futurama. Futurama's fantastic. It was a great show. It was so smart, too. Mm-hmm. Between proving the mathematical formulas and I don't know if you know this, but all the alien language that you see. It's actually in jokes. Like, it tells you shit about the episode. The language is real.
So they took the time to make up real language.
It was a real language, yeah. The creators of the show actually had a real alphabet, and it was a thing. It was a...
See, I love that stuff.
I can't think of what it's called off the top of my head, but when you use an alphabet that's just simply transposing letters for symbols, mm-hmm. that's what it is. It's a simple letter substitution. So if you figure out a key, you can sit there and read all that shit that they wrote, and it was all little in-jokes and things that you don't get just from watching the show. It's so smart.
Yeah.
Such a smart show.
I know, and I remember everything. What was the soda called that was like...
Slurm.
Slurm. Yeah, Slurm.
Slurm.
I think it was basically making fun of Surge or whatever. I don't know, but it was...
Surge, yeah. It did. Yeah. The can even sort of looked like Surge.
Because I even remember the very first episode I watched... Bender meets Fry at a suicide booth.
Yeah, suicide booth. Yep.
Yeah, I just I.
Yeah, and even that joke. I couldn't go on living when I found out what I was building, what the girders I was bending were for. What were they for? Suicide booths.
Yeah. and I don't remember I remember a lot of the Simpsons episodes, obviously, but I just, Futurama stuck out more in my mind for some reason. I think I enjoyed it more. It was more of my,
more your type of humor?
Yeah, just my type of humor. It's just...
And some of those episodes, my God, if you have a heart, they make you cry.
Oh, don't even get me started on that.
Oh my man. God. When Fry spelled out his love for Leela in the asteroids.
Yeah.
My God. Or the dog. Remember when his dog got...
Yeah. Yeah.
His petrified dog, he was trying to bring it back to life, and Bender got all jealous. And it shows, he lived for 10 more years after me. He probably had such a great life, and it showed a flashback, and it was just literally
him
Seymour sitting there waiting for him to come back in the rain until he finally laid down and died. I bawled like a bitch.
Yeah, I hate getting old.
I couldn't, nothing. I wasn't that old when that came out. I saw it. I cried like a little girl.
Yeah, how old was I when that came out? I don't even remember. But But I've been seeing stuff like that lately, and I think it's because I'm getting older. Do you remember me talking about... I watch Cartoon Network all the time. I don't care. Whatever. Fuck it. I love cartoons.
Whatever.
Yeah, I love cartoons. And Wee Bear Bears.
Bear Bears is pretty fun.
I love
my
that
kids
show.
Watch it.
Yeah,
I have an excuse. I have children. Casey's just a sad, lonely single man.
Yeah, I'm just a piece of shit that likes dead hookers and, you know. But...
He doesn't like the alive ones, only the dead ones.
Yeah, just the dead ones. You save money that way. But, yeah, exactly. There was this episode, I think we talked about this before, but they don't explain anything. The opening scene is these firefighters going to a tree, okay?
Mm-hmm.
They're going to a tree, they're walking up the tree, and they save the little brown one. What's his name?
Grizzly.
Grizzly. So they save him, they just cut it off, and they go back to when they're older. And I'm like, that's weird, they've never really done something like that. They usually, you know. So it's like... They go to a store and they have a burrito challenge where you eat all the burritos on the menu and the last burrito is like 10 pounds or something. Well, he finishes them all and the 10-pound burrito comes out and it's wrapped in foil and everything. He doesn't want to eat it. He comes obsessed with it. So he starts hugging it and takes it everywhere. He watches TV with it, feeds the popcorn. Well, you come to find out...
Feeds the burrito popcorn?
Yeah.
After a while, doesn't it become a popcorn burrito?
Actually, we're going to try that sometime. We're going to do that live.
Oh, God, Lord.
Popcorn burrito. Yeah, the man titties are going to grow.
God damn it.
But anyways, so then they're like, why is he acting so weird? So they finish the first scene at the beginning with the fire company.
Okay.
And Grizzly was a young little cub, and he was so scared when the fire people went up to grab him, he hugged the fireman's sleeve that had foil on it. You know how they have the reflective stuff?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So... That's why he was attracted to the burrito.
Oh, my God.
I know. I was looking around, making sure no one was looking at me. And I was like, okay, I could be a little bitch. And to see that on a cartoon show.
That's for kids, not like Futurama, which was for adults.
And, you know, kids are just like, you know, shoving, you know, high fructose corn syrup in their bodies, snorting chocolate bars, going, you know what? They're not paying attention to it.
Your parents were different than mine, apparently.
Yeah, they were. A little different, but I just thought that was crazy, and it just hit me in my feelings, man.
I love that show, but for another reason. Jason Lee plays Charlie the Sasquatch.
Oh God, I love him.
Oh my God, he's literally Earl from My Name Is Earl in the Sasquatch form. They even gave him a little mustache.
Yeah.
And I love Jason Lee. I don't know why. Ever since like the Clerks days, or not Clerks, he was in Mallrats. Mallrats. I love Jason Lee. It's a damn shame he's a fucking Scientologist.
Oh God.
He is. Yeah, he's a Scientologist. I think he actually ended up divorcing a wife because of it. She wasn't buying into the whole fucking crazy Xenu.
Yeah, she's like, sorry. I read the prenup and it said I'm allowed to leave if you're a crazy cult member. Sorry, that wasn't in the prenup.
I mean, you know, the fucking Church of Scientology likes to sue people who bitch about them, so we're probably fucked now.
Money.
But you know, Now we're gonna get sued by a Church of Scientology. But dude, those people are fucking nuts.
Oh, I know. I remember when the big deal was when Tom Cruise came out and you found out he was one. There was a lot of things.
Dude, Tom Cruise was a little nutty to begin with.
Oh yeah. Like, me and Jason.
I love Katie Holmes! I love Katie Holmes!
I know, like, don't drink the supper to the sink, Tom. Like, seriously.
Yeah, the Drano is not for consumption.
Yeah, like, I swear to God, before he came out and did that, he went to Oprah's sink and, like, funneled Drano into his butthole. Yeah. What would make you act like that?
Why is butthole, Casey? Why are we going to go to butthole?
I don't know. Like, did Katie Holmes suck that good of a dick that makes you act like that? Or are you just...
Katie Holmes left him.
Yeah.
And she largely blames Scientology.
Yeah, I would too.
Well, I mean, they believe that some fucking space lord from thousands of years ago banished a bunch of aliens into our volcanoes, and that's why we have bad feelings. I mean, does anybody listen to this shit?
Oh, man, that's just...
The problem is, though, you have to get so far into the ranks before they even tell you this shit, because...
Oh, there's ranks.
Oh, yeah, you got... And all the ranks are based on, basically, is paying money. So after you pay a certain amount of money to the church, you get to find out a little bit more, and a little bit more, and a little bit more.
So the first level's crazy, second...
No, the first level's actually fairly reasonable. Like, if you listen to the shit they try to lure you in with, it's pretty reasonable. I actually was somewhere. I was in a college campus when I went to school, and they had a Scientology recruitment thing going on there. And
wait,
it was
where?
I went to ITT years ago. And
the schools are
recruiting? No, the school. It was outside of the school.
Oh, okay.
They were doing a thing. I mean,
I was like, the schools are even.
Like,
on?
I got my first real checking account from one of the booths out there. But one of the vendor booths was a Scientology booth. And this was before, you know, South Park broke what the hell their doctrine is and shit, and it became well known just how crazy these fuckers were. In fact, I still remember seeing L. Ron Hubbard books, like Dianetics, being advertised on TV at this point. So not everybody knew that these people were absolutely batshit crazy at this point. So anyway, I went to this booth just for fucking fun, shits and giggles, and listened to what they had to say, and it actually sounded fairly normal.
Yeah. Well, that's how they... Yeah.
Well, yeah, they lure you in by being given people who need guidance exactly what they're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as, you know, you get further into the ranks, you have to pay more and more money, that's when you realize just how batshit insane this is. But by that point, people have invested so much into it, not just their time and their effort and their beliefs, but their money.
Yeah.
So it's harder for people to look at it and turn it away.
Yeah.
And that's exactly how they get you.
Yeah, you become so dependent on them, you can't leave them.
Right, and that's how a lot of cults operate.
Yeah.
You end up devoting so much of your time and effort into it that by the time you actually have gotten smart and realize just how fucking nuts they are, it's too late.
Mm-hmm.
You're already in. You're invested. And that's exactly what happened with a lot of people in Scientology, and some of the people that are, even that show I mentioned last week, Escaping Polygamy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm serious. If you haven't seen that show, you really need to.
Yeah, I'll have to look it up.
It's a Mormon sect, and Mormonism in itself is all right. I mean, I don't believe the things they believe, but it's fine. But some of the things that they talk about, this particular group, it's called the Kingstons. It's the Kingston clan, and they have...
See, anytime you have clan in your name, you're fucking crazy.
Yeah, they call themselves the Order.
Oh.
Which isn't ominous at all.
Oh.
And,
the Order.
The Order. Which isn't ominous at all, you know. But these people believe in marriage.
You keep using the word. I don't think it means what you think it means.
Yeah. Marriage, but they believe in marriage amongst, like, all these people, and they marry people as young as, like, 14. You get your first wife, which is your legal wife.
So you just get one.
They basically assign their wives.
Oh, my God.
And then, like, these four or five girls, they're all relatives, because everybody's pretty much a relative in this Kingston clan, because there's only so many fuck crazy people who will believe this shit, and most of them are relatives of one another. They all... end up basically interbreeding, and the oldest one of the group was actually being courted by her 42-year-old uncle, And she was still young enough that when she left the order, she was adopted by another family who she considers her real family. She changed her name, the whole nine. But now these girls, they're all family members. They've all gotten out of this, out of the order, and they dedicate their lives to helping other people escape, essentially. And this is a hugely powerful organization. They own tons of businesses. They own, like, this big biofuel. It's not just diesel, but it's, like, you know, heating oil and everything. They own this big biofuel production plant.
All these 14-year-old girls are marrying off's tears, probably, it's made out of.
Yeah. And these people are so brainwashed that they believe that this is just the way it is. And if you don't believe this way, you're going to hell.
You talking about this makes me feel like everything that's been going on the news lately is bullshit.
How so?
We shouldn't give a fuck about it. I think we should be
helping. Oh, like Hill Dog and Drumpf?
Yeah. And, you know, people not doing this that they don't like, or, you know,
yeah,
this person.
Yeah, there's hundreds of little girls.
Yeah, can we help these people?
They're working on it. They're working on it. People.
Oh, my God.
I guess.
Like, who gives a fuck if, you know, someone says something you don't like or, you know, hurts your...
I need a safe place.
Yeah, I need a safe place, you know?
Somebody made fun of me.
Can we... Can we help?
14-year-old girls are being recruited by their fucking uncles to be wives, like wealth wives.
Why aren't we focusing on this?
Well, we are somewhat. IRS went after these people, and don't fucking shit talk the IRS, man. They're the ones who took down Capone.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
When the feds couldn't do it, the IRS did it. You know, he went to prison for tax evasion.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah. So I mean, if the IRS raided their shit, that was on the last. It was on the season finale. I can't wait. I just discovered the show this season. If you're not watching it, you've got it.
What's it called again?
Escaping Polygamy. It's on A&E.
Ugh.
It's a great show. I can't believe... I mean, it's a reality show, so some of it, I'm sure, is scripted.
Oh, yeah.
I know for a fact that they reenact some of the interactions that they have with other people, but, I mean, the fact of the matter is they're still helping, basically, their siblings escape from this kind of reality.
Like, we have a lot of Amish people around here and stuff like that, and we basically just leave, but they're not like that.
Oh, sure. We do a show in Pennsylvania, and all of a sudden, everything's about the Amish.
Yeah.
You know, you'd be surprised. People believe that the Pennsylvania is all Amish.
Yeah.
We're not, I promise you.
We're not.
We personally happen to live in a very rural area.
Yeah, we do. And that's the thing. Like, I play online video games, and I play with people over the 50 states, and... A lot of people, I think, they don't realize how backwoods Pennsylvania is.
Yet again, back to my truck driving days.
Yeah.
It was only like 6 months of my life, but it was, I had a lot of memorable experience.
Probably, yeah.
One of my trainers at the time said, he's like, he was from Virginia, and West Virginia, actually, sorry. And he said, I guarantee you Pennsylvania's just as redneck as we are, because I've been following people in my truck. And they hit a deer, and they got out and gutted it and threw it in the back of their truck.
Oh, yeah. And that's the thing.
I may have done that once or twice.
Yeah. Like, I know we joke around and stuff like that, but we are being dead serious. My mom, she comes up to the bar that we work at every once in a while, and she came in, and I was like, hey, what can I get you to drink and stuff? She was like, she loves animals. Excuse me. She hates seeing them kill, and someone hit a deer on her way to, you know, come to the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, I think they were standing there arguing over who got it. And she had such this weird look on her face. But to me, I've lived out here so long, it's normal to me. I was that's good eating.
Yeah, I personally don't hunt because, to quote Ron White on this one, it's really cold, it's really early in the morning, and I don't want to go.
Yeah, exactly.
But I know enough people here that are willing to do it, and I love me some venison.
Yeah, and that's the thing.
Game you know meat. Why? Because it's free.
Yeah.
Money.
And it actually does happen out here. People find roadkill. They take it. They'll eat it.
I don't know anybody who's actually picked up somebody else's deer. Like, I've hit a deer and threw it in the back of the truck.
Yeah.
But I've never actually, like, come across one that's already been dead and be like, you know what?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go ahead and throw that in the truck.
Yeah. I don't know how many mammals I've eaten since I moved out here. I think I moved out here, what, 2-3 years ago? I've had, snake's not a mammal, but I've had snake. Sorry. God, this beer makes me gassy.
It is beer. Yeah. It's carbonated.
I had bear.
Squirrel.
Squirrel. It's just normal out here. It may not be normal to a lot of people, but out here, it's... If it has thighs and breasts, eat the fucking thing.
You know, it's... A lot of people know how to cook wild game, and a lot of people don't. I mean, it's got that gamey flavor.
Yeah.
So if you're not careful and you don't cook it right, it's going to taste funky.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you absolutely can cook it properly, and it tastes well. It usually requires some acid. If you put some tomatoes or some vinegar or something
in there. Yeah, I know. A lot of people use vinegar.
Right. It cuts that flavor out. When did this turn into Jay and Casey's cooking hour?
I don't know, but it just reminded me of our boss, a close friend of ours.
That's my stepfather.
Yeah, your stepfather. He shot a turkey. I forget what he did. I think he put some kind of Cajun seasoning on it or something, and he deep fried it. And we're eating it. It was at a Father's Day or something. We just all got around to hang out, and we were eating it, and we were like picking shotgun pellets out of it. You remember that? Were you there?
Yeah, you remember that shit in Back to the Future Part 3? It was played for a laugh. That's our reality.
Yeah, exactly. But that's normal to us. Like I said earlier, it's Pennsylvania is very... We're in the north, but God, are we backwoods.
Well, I mean, I live in a town of less than 500 people.
Yeah.
Casey lives in the next town over, which is less than 200 people.
Wait,
There's less than 200 people who live where you live. And one of them happens to be a kid toucher, but that's another story.
Oh, my goodness. Don't even get me started on that.
Yeah, it's rough.
So, there's actually 500 people where you live?
If you include the upper region.
I was going to say, I didn't think it was that many.
Yeah, it's about 500 people. But anyway, speaking of movies and TV and shit... Did you hear what Adam Driver had to say about the Star Wars Episode 8?
No.
Well, he said that the new Star Wars film coming out was going to be... he said it was a different tone, was the word he used.
So they're not going to make him look like a little bitch.
Oh, no, they're going to make him look like a little bitch. Yeah, the internet exploded and said that I guess that means it's going to be fucking dark and gritty instead of the fucking... Basically, New Hope Part 2.
Yeah.
But he says, oh, no, and that's not even what I said. What I said was the tone of it was different. I didn't say that it was going to be in the vein of... I was using it as an example, so poor example. Next time I should say, I'm trying to think of another sequel to a movie that's good. When I read the script, it was not what I expected in the best of ways. So anyway, he backpedaled what he said. But you know what? That movie, I'm not a Star Wars fan, I know you are. But you know what? I watched it. He was great. Kylo Ren was a great villain for the first half of the movie. Then he took his helmet off and...
I know.
Badass, helmet off, bitch.
Yep. I just... Oh, man. We got to talk about Star Wars, man. He turned into such a little bitch. Star Wars... This film made me excited about Star Wars again. It really did.
Why? It was the same fucking plot line as The New Hope.
But it just... It seemed like there was effort put into it. But...
Well, effort to rip off
Jay,
the original.
I can't do it. I can't do it. I get too riled up, man. And
get
I know,
riled up. It was fucking bullshit.
I know, but it's just, I know it's a fucking movie.
J.J. Abrams and his member berries.
Yeah, this fucking movie, when I first started watching it, had me so fucking rock hard. I had the biggest rager.
Oh, what, when he stopped the laser beam with his hand?
Oh, my God. I saw that and I was like, who is this motherfucker? Like, I wanted, when I saw him do that, I was like, I want this fucker to bring out gangster rap albums. That's how excited I was.
I'm going to pick up where you left off, Darth Vader.
Yeah.
Come on, what kind of bullshit is that? Where did he leave off?
And that's
being a little girl?
Yeah, and I know I explained this to you before, but when he took off his helmet, it ruined it for me for a little bit. But it not as bad as other people. And that's because I've seen this movie called We Need to Talk About Kevin, and he sort of looks like this serial killer guy. For you watching YouTube and everything, I'll post a picture of him. It's almost the same thing. But
I'm sorry. There's nothing scary about Kylo Ren. Kylo Ren's a bitch.
I know.
Did you see the SNL thing where they made fun of him? Oh my God. The undercover boss.
Where's
thing?
My muffin, Matt? I love that. I think that is fucking hilarious. And that's
link that in the description.
Yeah, I will. You got to watch it.
You've got to watch
the
SNL.
If you haven't
thing.
Seen the SNL thing, they do an undercover boss skit of Kylo Ren at the Death Star. It is fucking hilarious. He's a
Kylo
raider.
Straight up, sir. Matt straight up sucks. Yeah,
it's so funny.
Oh, it's great.
Oh, but just that movie started off so good, and then out of nowhere, it just went to fucking
all right,
shit.
You know what? I'm going to sit here as somebody who does not like Star Wars. I know, shoot me, whatever. Yeah. I don't think Star Wars is that fucking great of a movie. I was kind of a Star Trek guy when I was a little kid. My dad brought me up on it. Okay, whatever. Anyway, so Star Wars is okay. Whatever. I watched it and it was okay, but you know, like you got fucking Poe, who seemed like a badass, the pilot guy, but they say, oh, he's the best pilot in the Resistance. Show me.
Yeah.
At no point do they show you that Poe's a badass.
I know.
I mean, at the end when they're all storming Death Star Part 2, the fucking planet size edition.
Yeah. Are you talking about a new? Oh, you're talking about the new movie.
Oh,
sorry.
Yeah, sorry. Same fucking movie. when they're storming the Star Killer base, because, you know, enough in-jokes to fucking choke a horse. When they're storming the Star Killer base, he's there with, like, 10 other people who are all storming it. Okay, so he's not doing anything special. Tell me about him. He's the only interesting character.
Mm-hmm.
You've got fucking Jar Jar, you know, Jar Jar Finn, who's there as mainly comic relief. And then you got Rey, the goddamn space wizard.
Yeah, she just fucking knows. That's what I hated. She knows fucking everything.
Oh, yeah. Like, oh, I can read your mind because fuck you. That's why.
Yeah, just and that's the thing. They don't. And don't even. Oh, my God. We need more time.
We got all the time. You're editing. We got all the time in the world.
Fucking Rey. Okay, don't even. Rey was my most hated character. I fucking hated her. Exactly. Fuck her. She was so horribly written.
She was just like, hey, let's just turn our heads and she knows everything.
Yeah.
There's no internal struggle. There's nothing.
And going
there's
back,
no conflict.
Yeah, going back to the struggle thing, Luke, straight up, his life was shit. His life was fucking
horrible.
Well,
so was Ray's, if you look at that.
I mean, know, but they really don't explain it. There's no
we're
time
talking to... about another person in a desert planet, moisture farming... You know?
Yeah.
Or, oh no, I'm sorry, she's a scavenger.
Yeah. Luke, you know, his fucking parents, or his uncle, or whatever it was.
What the hell is his name?
No, I don't know. I just know that's the blue milk scene.
The blue milk scene.
They get fucking killed. He gets his hand cut off right after, or I think it was before, his fucking guy that cuts his hand off says, I'm your fucking father. All right, goes back, they feel like they're defeated. He finally, you know, that's what gets me close to characters is the struggle. Rey's character was like, yeah, I can do that because of the Force. I can do this fucking Millennium Falcon. I'm going to fly it. You know why? The fucking Force.
Because fuck you. That's why. Because fuck you, audience.
And one of my most hated things is Kylo Ren, like we said, about stopping the fucking lights, the laser with his hand. You're like, who is this fucker? This guy, you know, this guy's going to just rape and pillage. Rey's like, I picked up a lightsaber. I touched it for the first time, and she beats him. What the fuck was that?
Yeah, that's just. I mean, he was. Some people are gonna nerds are gonna sit there in the comments and say, oh, well, he was already wounded.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry, Darth Vader wouldn't have mattered if he was already fucking wounded.
And
the
then
only
the
thing that stopped
thing.
Darth.
Yeah.
The only thing that stopped Darth Vader was Darth Vader.
Yeah, exactly. He was. Yeah, and the wounded thing. That's another thing. He's so badass, and then all of a sudden, after he kills his fucking father.
If you haven't
Chewie,
seen a 2-year-old movie, you can kiss my ass.
Chewie from fucking, you know, Europe shoots a fucking direct shot right into his side. So he's stopping late. I don't know if they shot this in two separate things, but you could just tell that there was this period of where they were like, okay, fuck it.
I mean, you know, the best summary of the whole thing is if you recall, Han and Jar Jar Finn go down onto the Star Killer base, which is an entire fucking planet, mind you, and decide that they're going to go try to find Phasma because, you know, she wouldn't be guarded or whatever. and stop her or get the codes or some fucking shit, I forget, from her. And
to lower the shields.
Yeah, to lower the shields.
Which was never
right.
in a Star Wars film ever.
Yeah,
and
never
they
before.
Never did that.
And what is it? Han says to Finn, how you planning on doing this? And he said, or how you planning on finding her? It's like, oh, we'll use the Force. The Force doesn't work that way. Although in that entire movie,
I know.
Yeah, that's exactly how the Force works.
That's exactly how I don't know if that was an inside joke or not. It had to have been because it was so obvious. Because like we were talking about,
just that's right, all though. That was. That was lazy
yep.
writing.
Yep.
And then they managed to find Phasma off camera. And they managed to extract the information from her off camera. Lazy fucking writing.
Yeah, it seemed like they put a lot of, because I know it was practical effects and everything. I think that took up a lot of time. It seemed like they were under pressure or something, and they were rushed to make, because it just the rest of the movie after the beginning just didn't make sense.
Well, they were rushed to make a movie that was safe and will make money.
Money.
Exactly.
money. And I wish. And when I first left the theater, I was like, okay, he played it safe, obviously.
Money.
And then I just, now that I think about it, I wish he took the chance.
Money.
That's true.
Fucking Disney, man. You give the mouse control of your properties, and this is exactly what happens.
I know, and like, I loved Kylo Ren at the beginning. I fucking loved him.
He's such a bitch.
Him with his little Lego helmet on, I didn't mind that. It looked like he, you know, just picked that up at Toys R Us.
He's such a bitch.
I know, and then they just turn him this fucking...
Oh, I'm mad. I'm going to wreck the entire room with my lightsaber because I'm a fucking bitch.
I can't take over the galaxy. My Chemical Romance, you know, new album came out.
Oh, my God. My math test was so hard.
Yeah, I just hope that they do what has been successful for a long time, and it's not just Star Wars. I've seen this in a lot of movies. They don't put the main character through enough suffering, which helps character development. When you see a character suffer, you want him to succeed. You want him to be better. I didn't see a lot of suffering in that movie. I just think it was poorly written. It wasn't like Luke, where that motherfucker went through some shit. He really went through some shit.
Oh my God! I mean, you know, the only fucking conflict in that whole thing is why does Maz Kitana have the fucking goddamn lightsaber?
I know, and they didn't even explain it. Like,
we'll talk about that later.
Yeah, she just basically says, she's like, Rey's like, oh, well, what's it doing here? And she's like, oh, that's not important now. I'm like, were you guys drunk at a Starbucks or something that you're just like, we don't know how to explain that. Let's just, you know. Get rid of that. We'll just say, later.
Oh, my God. If you guys are on Twitter, you need to look up Emo Kylo Ren. It is the best fucking account on the face
that
of the planet.
That is really funny. After we both seen the movie, we follow him on Twitter, and he just posts some of the most amazing shit.
Right. Like, he's got, first, I will reunite my chemical romance next to the Empire.
It's great. What's it called again? The full name?
It's Emo Kylo Ren. It's at KYLOR3N.
Yeah, because me and Jay were talking about this, and it's obvious that we're not the only ones that feel this way.
This whole Rogue One movie sounds like biased anti-imperial propaganda, but I will go just to see footage of Darth Vader in his prime. Violently overturns every table in the galaxy. This day means nothing to me. Dear Diary, I was not appointed prom monarch. This should not affect me. I'm not even disappointed.
Matt would have done it. Matt?
I didn't even get my muffin yet, Matt. Yeah.
But when the new one comes out, we're probably going to talk about this more. I'm very passionate about Star Wars.
Star Wars.
I know. And that's the thing. I just love it, and it... And like I said, it got me really excited about Star Wars again. It really did. It's just, you can tell that something happened midway in the movie.
Well, what the hell did you think was going to happen? You let Disney control your properties, and now all of a sudden, fucking Leia as a Disney princess.
Yeah. Oh, is she really?
Of which, well, yeah, think about it. She's a princess. Leia, Disney owns the property. She's a Disney princess. By
shit, yeah. I never thought of that.
Which really makes some of her Comic-Con mashups that you see of the Disney princess and the slave Leia outfit kind of pointless.
Yeah, that should be at Disney stores. That's
sort of redundant now.
Yeah.
Fucking, you remember that shit that they had on TV about, or on TV, online, Leia. She was talking about how people are expecting her to look the same she did when she was like 23 video.
Yeah.
It's like, come on, all you angry nerds out there.
I know, like, when she got on TV, I could picture this guy's thing of Jerkins or whatever the fuck that shit's called.
Jerkins.
You know that company made it like that, so people mistake the word.
I'm not thinking you did.
And there was a thing of Kleenex there, and they're all ready. They're like, yeah, man, I can't wait. They're, like, rubbing their nipples or something, whatever nerds do. And she comes out. Oh, my God. Yeah, she comes out, and then it just, the full rager goes down to zero. Like Captain Planet, take pollution down to zero. That rager went down to zero. And just imagine these nerds just... And it's like you can't... When the first one come out? 77 or something?
Something like 77.
Yeah, how old is she? She's not going to have a body like that. Get the fuck over it.
Carrie Fisher is not going to look like she did when she was 20 feet.
Yeah, like... Get fucking real here.
Like, wipe the Cheeto dust off your fucking chin. Yeah,
and stop jerking off of Mountain Dew and Doritos or whatever the fuck...
You know, fucking, if you're going to have a beard, make sure it grows all the way.
Yeah. Neck beard. And she, after Star Wars or whatever, she was in the Blues Brothers movie.
She was in lots of stuff.
Yeah, and then just after that, she didn't really show her face for a while. She said she even admitted it, which
well,
I can
she
respect.
Was a writer. Here's the thing, I don't know if you know this. She actually wrote a lot of screenplays after that. She was a... one of the people that rewrote, like, say somebody, some fucking nerd at Starbucks came up with a screenplay.
Mm-hmm.
She was one of the people that they would go to rewrite it into something that could actually be filmed.
Oh, okay. All right.
So she had a very long,
fruitful
career after Star Wars.
Yeah.
It's just she wasn't in front of the screen. She was behind it.
Yeah. And it's funny that people would think that after how many years she'd come out still looking like she did. People get old. Like, I know it ruins your jerk-off fantasies, but seriously. it's just too much sometimes, Jay.
I mean, come on, man. We all get bitch tits when we get older. Yeah. Dudes. We all start sagging a little bit.
And she didn't even try to bullshit. She was like, yeah, I was a fucking alcoholic. I did a bunch of drugs and stuff like that. She even admitted.
Well, she came out in the 70s, you know? Who didn't?
Yeah.
Quaaludes were handed out like fucking chips at that point.
I know.
It's like you had the Ritz crackers here, and you had the fucking Quaaludes right here, man.
It's like
those
old-time bars where the flapper girls are walking around with the cigarette packs. There's like fucking drugs and Quaaludes and all sorts. Yeah, that was...
People were doing uppers and downers. They were doing the uppers to get off the downers.
Yeah, diagonal, whatever.
Fucking sideways.
Oh, man, that's fucking funny.
I mean, come on, man. If you don't expect Carrie Fisher to show a little age... You're out of your mind.
Nah. I think they just... All these nerds had this, you know, slave outfit. Yeah. And this fantasy that she was choking Jabba the Hutt.
She can choke my Jabba the Hutt.
How fucking about it? I give that 3 thumbs up.
Oh, my God. Fucking nerds.
Yeah. But I think that's pretty much it for today, isn't it, Jay?
Yeah, I think that'll about do it. Remember, kids, the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast is available on iTunes, Google Play, YouTube, and your favorite podcasting platform. If you're enjoying what we do here, be sure to subscribe, like, favorite, and review. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus. Feel free to drop us a line. And any comments you want to post below, we'll be happy to read.
Yes.
All right.
We plan on... You know, there's going to probably be some hate, so we want to do an episode where people are making fun of us. I think that'd be a lot of fun.
Well, we're definitely going to come to you every week on Wednesdays.
Yes, we record Tuesdays, and then we're going to be releasing them every Wednesdays.
All right, well, we look forward to seeing you next week.
Yep, thank you very much. Have a good one.